yeah. Sometimes I shave my legs and sometimes I don't. Sometimes I comb my hair and sometimes I won't.
Hey, welcome back to my channel. This week I want to do a book review because I feel like I haven't done one in such a long time. So the book that the author that I've decided to work with today is Shani Mootoo. She is an Indo-Caribbean writer who basically writes back to her Caribbean experience. And what I really like about her texts is that they deal with a lot of, I would start with transgender narratives, as well as the question of sexuality. So most of her texts, although they are focused on what's happened in the time, surround most of the main characters who are dealing with their gender identity. So I have three texts. For the life of me, I cannot find the first text that I read that introduced me to her, but because I read it twice, because I had two classes with the same book, I know it fairly well. That text that I'm referring to is Cereus Blooms at Night. It's a flower, so if you know the pronunciation, good. So that text was a wonderful text because it basically talked about how the Caribbean society dealt with people who were different. So the text had a lot of storylines intertwining with each other. The main storyline is of this woman who we encounter her as an old woman who ends up being assumed as mad. But what nobody really knows, and this is what I really like about the text, is that this woman has been brutally raped and abused by her father for over 20 years until some way she was able to ... I won't ruin the end for you because I do want you to read it, but she was brutally raised by her father. Her sister ran away because her sister was also raped, but she didn't want to endure the pain and the psychological pain that this one woman endured was so hard that she couldn't even leave after ... So what I really like about this text is it doesn't only focus on the pain and suffering of the main character, it dives into different histories and stories of other characters. And one character that I really liked, which at first when I was reading it, they didn't actually stick with me until I read it a couple more times, and that was the character who was the love interest of the grandma. So the old lady and her boyfriend, they weren't able to make it work because she had the trauma and pain of the rape. So when she was finally giving in to her sexuality, she realized that all the stuff that her father did to her wasn't actually what she wanted from him, but from somebody else. And anyways, long story short, they weren't able to be together. So the guy found another wife to marry him, but he was in love with the mad woman, so he never really loved that woman, and he basically spent his life in his bed. The only good thing that came out of his life was his daughter. And what I want to say in terms of the trans narrative is the daughter started off as a wonderful, beautiful girl, but throughout the years she transformed into a man, and nobody really questioned it because, well, one, she was an attractive boy, and two, whenever you do whenever you transform genders, it's usually more comfortable for a woman to say, I'm gay or I want to do this, than it is for men, especially black men who have been prosecuted for being gay. You can see that if a black woman comes out and says, I'm gay, most people are praising, like, yay, free son. But when you see a guy, they're like, no, faya mafi bandam, or, you know, all of those things that are negative. In this instance, I like that she transformed into a man without anybody really noticing or arguing. Both parents were accepting and they just took it as it was because they knew she was different from the start, but they didn't inquire about it. Long story short, Cereus Blooms at Night is a really great text because it talks about the Caribbean history from an Indo-Caribbean perspective, as well as from a trans narrative, where you do get that perspective of what it is to feel like a person stuck in your body that you don't really actually feel like you personally should fit into, as well as it touches on a narrative of abuse and rape and living beyond that trauma. So if you are ever interested in an Indo-Caribbean text, Cereus blooms at night. The next text I have from her is Valmiki's daughter. I have not actually had the opportunity to read this. Initially, this was the text we were supposed to read instead of moving forward sideways like a crab. But because of publication issues, we weren't able to read it. But I bought all my books on Amazon on the first day of class. So I still ended up getting this book and I was like, damn, I wasted my money. But after I read the two texts from Shani Mootoo, I realized that this is possibly an investment because her texts are really, really good. So I'm just going to read the blurb and let you get an insight of what this text would be. And if you like it, you can enjoy it and read it and let me know how you feel about that text. The next text that I have read from her is Moving Forward Sideways Like a Crab. This text, again, is focused on trans narrative. And that is because the main character that is about to tell the story about her father is telling the father's story as a woman who transformed into a man and the choices and repercussions that came after she made that full commitment to get that surgery. And what I like about this text is that it talks about the Trinidadian history in a lens that you wouldn't really see it in, because it is, if you take it in, Shani Mootoo, an Indo-Caribbean writer, writing in the perspective of a white Caribbean who is writing about Indo-Caribbean man / woman, depending on how you categorize her at that moment. And in the story, it's basically the son's journey to accepting his father after the transition. Because after the father transitioned from woman to man, the wife of the son that is doing the writing decided that he wasn't going to keep the woman in the life, because at that point when the two wives had met, like the two women before he transformed into a man, she had fell in love with a white woman who created a man from the false insemination. So she had a child and they were together, so she ended up inadvertently raising the child while this woman was writing the book. Anyways, after the child gets older, they start arguing. The separation ruins a lot of ties because the child and the transgender woman is very close until they aren't close anymore. So years later, when the transgender woman is on her dying bed for natural causes, she is now relaying her story to her son and letting him know that there's always two sides to every story. And that's why it's moving forward sideways like a crab, because they're moving forward, but they're actually recognizing what's going on. Like, they're looking at it, they're looking at the past, as opposed to just moving forward without actually seeing the past in your peripheral. When you're moving sideways, the past is on this side, the future is on this side, but you're still moving forward. So I really do like that text. And what is really great about the text is that you never really expect all that you get out of this, because there's so many different turns and twists that come out of this text that make it so much more fulfilling to read and understand. Valmiki's daughter, Scotiabank Giller Prize finalist and best-selling novelist Shani Mootoo, offers a hugely entertaining, hypnotically beautiful family saga about the corrosive power and secrets and the competing pulls of race, class, and sexuality. The story centers on a wealthy Trinidadian family, in particular, Valmiki, a renowned doctor and loving, if confused, father, and his eldest daughter, Viviga, lively, intelligent, and intent on escaping the gilded cages that protect but also smooths her. With the masterful novel, Mootoo gives us a vibrant, sexy, gorgeous book full of vigorous stuff of life. So I'm not too sure what this entails, but it does sound very interesting. I'm thinking it has something to do with the doctor, because that's the book, Valmiki's Daughter. It may be about the daughter as well, but when you're talking about a text and you're looking at the title to figure out what's going on, if it was about the daughter, it would have said Vivica, right? Vivica instead of Valmiki's daughter. So there has to be a connection to him. Anyways, I'm interested in this text. It seems very interesting, and it isn't that big of a read. There's only 392 pages. For me, that isn't a lot. After I had to throw down 500-page books, like, these ones are nothing to me. So if you do ever get a chance, read it and let me know what you think. So that is it for today. I just wanted to give you a little bit of insight into Shani Mootoo, simply because she is a really great writer. And I want us to see that our history is very intertwined. It doesn't only rest in the Black experience. It comes from the Indians, it comes from the Asians, and it comes from everyone who has experienced depression in some form, shape, or way. And that is because when the indentured laborers came down to the Caribbean, they were oppressed. And as much as you can say, oh, well, they took the jobs of the Black people, made it harder for them to get to a specific position, they were still brought here on false promises. They were still manipulated and they were still treated poorly. So we still have to hear their stories and see what pain and suffering that they endured, because we are not the only ones that suffer. And if we act like we are the only ones that suffer, we will lose the sympathy. And I don't want to lose any sympathy. I want to gain sympathy and recognize that everyone in our community has pain. Everyone in our community has suffering. And until we recognize it and read it, we won't be able to undermine it. Well, that is all I had to say this week. Thank you again for joining me. I know it is very tough to sit down and watch all of that I have to say, because I do have a lot to say. But when you stick with me, I feel happy, and making me happy makes the world happy, because you know, it starts with you making one person happy, and then it's a train effect, you know? But anyways, thank you for joining me, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time, have a great day, life, month, and year.